Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. It's Kim with Kim's Inspired Life. Guys, this weekend I have been working on mini pocket letters. I don't know why, but about 2 weeks ago I was watching something. Maybe it could have been Pinterest or YouTube. I don't know. And I was just so inspired by these little tiny pocket letters. And they're so cute. Oh my gosh. So I'm going to show them to you in the order that I made them. And then I wanted to tell you first that I just used a regular sheet protector, you know, the 8.5 by 11, and I was able to cut two of them because each of the pocket letters are 5 by 4.5, and so and then the other parts I saved because I don't know, I might be able to use them for something in the future, so they just are in the container. So the first one I made, this one actually was about 2 weeks ago. Just the last 2 weeks have just been crazy, guys. Oh my gosh. Anyway, so I was inspired by this little tiny coffee cup. I just thought that was so cute and I wanted to use that. So this mini pocket letter has 9 squares, and then I just so far have left this blank before I send it off to the person that I'm sending it to, which I'm pretty sure I know who this is going to. Then I'll just decorate it up with something fun right there. And the back is just blank. And so you can see that I used my fuse tool to fuse, and don't look too closely. They're kind of wonky and not so straight. I got better as we got to the end of the pile. But so I used my fuse tool there and then just put on some chipboard pieces here. So the second one I made, I just went in right into my scrap box, and I wanted to use paper that I thought was fun, and I was thinking summer. So I found this paper, which actually has, it's double-sided, so there is a back to it. And then I started seeing where people were just leaving a square blank and then just maybe putting in like a little filler. And so this is just an enamel heart flat back that I put there. And so this, since this one is about summer, I found this chipboard piece here that says let's play in the sand, and then camera with smile, and then I like these hearts, and this is a chipboard piece, and there's a tag back here. So, and then I just use the black again right here to draw out the black that is in parts of the paper right there. And then I'll so that was the second one that I made. And then the third one I made, I started seeing pocket letters where they were basically, where people were just basically using the pocket letter as a canvas and then just using some larger types of decorations. And I've had this wood free spirit. Actually, that was gifted to me. I don't remember who that came from. It was quite a while ago, along with this heart. And then, so of course, I thought that, you know, I wanted to try to bring out something from these colors here, but I found that cross and I just thought, I just like that. And since the paper in the back, again, this was in my scrap bucket, had the eyelashes and the bobby pins on it, I thought I should do something with eyes. So I found those two little pieces there. Then I wanted to try out some washi tape since I hadn't used washi tape on any of the other pocket letters. So I put that washi tape there, and then I just happened to run across this. It was the same color, so I thought, well, you know, I'll put that on there too. So that one turned out kind of fun too. I like the gray and the green together. And then I found these pieces of heart embossed white on there. So I thought, okay, I'll use those. But then, I don't know if you can tell, but this square over here was a little bit longer than these. And of course, I didn't get it in my mind that I should just cut off this a little bit over here. I don't know why I didn't think about that until later. And so I just went ahead and found paper that could fit in there, which was like 1.5 inches versus like 1 inch or something, or 1.75 inches. And so then that one, that's why that one's a little bit different, but it is gray, and that's okay. And then I had this piece that I've been wanting to use it on something. And so I thought to bring out the pink over here, I could put that happy there. And then somebody had gifted me these in some happy mail, I think, or in a swap. So I really like these. I have two other pieces of this white with the gold chipboard that I really like. So I thought I'd put there because when I think about happy, I think about the beach. That's my happy place. And in order to get to my happy place, I have to work hard, but then, you know, play hard too. So I bought these on the Magical Mixery, these orange, or these pink enamel hearts. I think these are waffle hearts, are so fun. And then I just used some of this this sparkly thread over here. And then I like tags. I mean, I try to use any kind of little tag or banner what I can. And that was in my little scrap bucket of die cuts. And so I thought that was fun too. And then I had been wanting to put this on one of the pocket letters. And so I thought this one's a good one to bring out that white right there. And then of course, florals. I love the mixture of florals and polka dots together. I just think that's really cool. So anyway, and then every time I put a sentiment on, I always, you know, think that you have to put an enamel dot right there. I don't know why. I don't know. It just looks, I'm trying to bring out the gold too over here. So, and then there's gold in the paper too. So, okay, there's that one. And then the next one I made, so I had been gifted this Tim Holtz little ephemera pack. I don't remember by whom, but in the pack, most of the pieces, I mean, I didn't have to cut these at all. This is the size they were. And then it's like little tiny things. And then all these little things right here, all these little tiny pieces of paper, ephemera paper, that was in the pack as well. So I thought, oh, okay, I can do me a little, you know, Tim Holtz little inspired pocket letter. And you can see that now I went to the 6 boxes versus the 9 boxes. So I thought, oh yeah, let me do 6 boxes because I just measured it, and then I just did the math and I thought, okay, this can work. And then of course I needed to add some little 3D pieces here. I can't remember, I got a whole bag of these little things, I think on Amazon, came in a little, you know, bag of all, you know, like 100 pieces of all these little things. And then this little shoe, isn't that so cute? That was in an embellishment box that I either received from a giveaway prize or someone gave that to me. I think it may have been from Carmen's Treasures, but that's so cute. And then, of course, I just used the brown over here. I'll probably add something to it later, but I thought that was kind of cute. And the last one I did was this one, of course, because it's almost 4th of July, and I had these already. Heart, the USA. They're Doodlebug, and then I just put the glitter paper on the back of them so that they could stand out. And like I said, I had seen pocket letters where they didn't put paper in the back, they just left it clear and then just put, you know, something interesting on the inside. And then of course, so I made this a shaker. So there's, you know, I had this red, white, and blue that I think it's Park Lane maybe, or Time and Place I got from Joann's, and or Michael's maybe. And so I thought, oh, I have to use this red, white, and blue. So the stars are part of the Doodlebug collection. This little pinwheel I bought like 6 on a page or 9 on a page, I think at Michael's one time. And so I didn't do anything to that. It came just like that. And then this heart is just a, you know, punch. So, and then I had this already, this heart. So I thought heart, you know, I had this heart lace. So I put that there. So I thought this turned out really cute too. And I think I'm going to do more of these where I do shakers. And then I'm going to gift this to someone. So I went ahead and put some of the shaker bits inside one of these Dollar Tree little containers right here. So that'll be part of a little, you know, gifty happy meal. I think it's a happy meal I'm going to be sending out. So anyway, I thought I would share this with you because, guys, I just love, love, love minis. Oh my gosh. Anything I can do that is mini, I just think they're so cute. So I hope that you're inspired to make some too. And again, I used my fuse tool. I'm not kidding. It took me about the fourth one to really figure out how to use my fuse tool. This is the first time I've really used it much. I used it a couple of times, but not much. So anyway, guys, today is Father's Day. So have a happy Father's Day to all of you that are celebrating today. And best wishes for all of you. And I will talk to you again soon. Bye-bye.